It's not until 2019 that countries of the world started implementing the use of face masks in schools and places of work. There are two reasons for wearing a mask. First is to shield yourself from physical harm, or, like in the case of a pandemic, reducing the possibility of contracting a disease. And the second reason is to conceal or hide a portion of your face. Here is a fun fact. Not every mask is designed to hide or conceal a thing. Some masks are designed to show or reveal something instead. Let's look at this date, for example, 09-07-06. We cannot tell whether the month is September, July, or June, or what day of the year it is. This is because all parts of the date look the same and no format was specified. The format we need to interpret this date is called a date format mask, since it reveals details such as the actual positions of day, month, and year. Similarly, an IP address, as discussed in the previous video, is a 32-bit address used for network layer communication. This IP address contains two important information, the network ID and host ID components, and both are used to identify the location of a device. To visualize the concept of locating a device, every house on the same street will have the same street name, but the house numbers will differ. For Jonathan Street, each house has a unique house number. By comparing this with computer networks, the street is the local area network segment, the houses are the computers and devices with IP addresses, the street name is a network identifier, and the house number is the host identifier for any host device. This information cannot be obtained directly from just the IP address, since all parts of an IP address look the same. It can, however, be obtained using the subnet mask of that IP address. The real question is, what is a subnet mask? Hello guys, today we'll talk about the subnet mask. Let us understand subnet mask using this battery level indicator. There are 32 bars used to show the power level of this battery. Finally, the green portion tells us the amount of power left, and the gray portion tells us the amount of power used. In a similar way, a subnet mask is a 32-bit value which consists of consecutive ones followed by consecutive zeros. The number of ones reveals the network ID portion of the IP address to which it is applied, and the zeros tells the host ID portion. The ones are always on the left, followed by zeros on the right. It is necessary to note that you cannot have ones between zeros or zeros between ones. But how is this subnet mask applied to an IP address? Assume the IP address 172.16.43.1 is configured on a device and we were to extract the network and host ID that can be used to describe the device's location. We first convert this to binary form to obtain this. And let's assume that the subnet mask given consists of only the first three octets filled with ones. The length of the ones tells us the portion of our IP address that carries the network ID, and the others describe the host ID portion, which corresponds to the position of zeros in the subnet mask. Therefore, the network ID for the given IP address and subnet mask is 172.16.43.0, and the host ID is 0.0.0.1, or just 1 when converted to decimal. There are 5 classes of IP addresses, but the class A, B, and C IP addresses are usually configured on devices. By default, the IP addresses from Class A have a subnet mask with only 8 ones. This subnet mask can be represented in two general ways: converting to decimal, otherwise known as the dotted decimal, or using a prefix length. This gives 255.0.0.0 or /8 prefix length. Class B IP addresses have default masks consisting of 16 ones, which corresponds to the dotted decimal value of 255.255.0.0 or /16 prefix length. Class C IP addresses have default masks consisting of 24 ones, which corresponds to the dotted decimal value of 255.255.255.0 or /24 prefix length. These are only their default subnet mask values, as the length may be shorter or longer for some application areas. This will be discussed in future presentations. Check out the questions on the next slide. If you like this video, you can give it a thumbs up and subscribe to our YouTube channel. Please turn on notifications so you'll be the first to know when we release a new video. Thank you for watching.